Hello and welcome back to our channel. I'm Colleen and this is Our Blessed Life. And today's video is going to be a review and flip through of Happy Cheetah Reading, a reading program for struggling readers. So I'm going to be talking about the kindergarten and first grade levels, as well as showing you, just giving you a glimpse of the other levels online on Happy Cheetah's website. And I'll also be going through how it's working so far for my daughter Sophie. We purchased Happy Cheetah Reading for my daughter Sophie, who has special needs. She has a rare genetic condition called SETD5. She's in second grade, she's 9 years old, and we have just been really struggling to find a way to get her to read, to get her to start learning to read. Even though she knew all of her phonic sounds and all of that, it just wasn't clicking. And so Happy Cheetah Reading was something that we thought we would try. Prior to this, we had used Abeka, The Good and the Beautiful, as well as Language Lessons for Living Education and Foundations Phonics. So we finally had success with Foundations Phonics with getting her to learn all the letter sounds and even starting to pick up some sight words. So that was probably the most success that we had had with any product other than the like preschool Good and the Beautiful. But when we got into the Good and the Beautiful's kindergarten level, that's kind of where we got stuck. Okay, so I am reading from the company's website. HappyCheetah.com is the website for Happy Cheetah Reading. And it says, Happy Cheetah Reading works for beginning readers, remedial readers, special needs readers, English as a second language. And they also advertise that there's no electronics needed, there's no prep time, and they have a 100% money back guarantee.
This is the Happy Cheetah Reading website, and I just wanted to show you what they have as far as options. First of all, they do have the ability for you to take an assessment to determine what level your child would need. And they do have a little bit of a discount if you buy the whole system. So this would be like all of the levels. And then they have every level separately. So we purchased the Happy Cheetah Reading for kindergarten because I really didn't want to spend $399 not knowing if this product would work for my my daughter. So we purchased this, and Sophie is now almost complete with this level. And so I have also purchased the first grade. But they do have Happy Cheetah Reading levels for kindergarten, first grade, and second grade. Then they have this experience booster kit, which we did not purchase. And then they have the individual workbook. So for example, if you had twins or two children at the same level, you could buy an extra student book. However, the one complaint that I do have about the way they sell this is if you're like me and you don't want to buy the whole kit, then you do end up with duplicates of some of the things, like they send you the magnetic letters again and the whiteboard and all that kind of stuff. So I'll show you when I open up the first grade kit, some of the things that are duplicates that we really didn't need. So it does come in a box like this, and the entire level comes. So when we started with kindergarten, we really only needed book two, but there was no way to get the kindergarten level without getting book one as well. So we had to pay for the whole thing. I also just wanted to point out that Happy Cheetah Reading is for kindergarten, first grade, and second grade. Okay, so this is one thing that they do say on here. Once students have finished Happy Cheetah, which would be the second grade level, they read at a mid-third grade level and are ready for chapter books. All right, so I just wanted to hit on a couple of big things as far as their claims with how it works, just so that I can speak to those later. So I'm right on their website, and I just went to how does Happy Cheetah Reading work? Okay, so it says big picture plus smaller parts. So the student always starts listening to the full story without focusing on rules or individual sounds. So when you start Happy Cheetah, if they're in the first book, the parent will actually read the entire book before they start the lesson, or the entire set of stories before the student is asked to read it on their own. And that is helpful. They do connect new information to old information. So when you move from one book, so there will be a few books that are in each level, and as they move from one thing to the other, vocabulary is continued and it's built upon. Celebrating the strengths, ignoring the weaknesses, so you're focusing on their achievements. And the big thing that I think has helped with Sophie is the repetition. There's so much repetition. I recently did a review of Rod and Staff Arithmetic 1, and Extreme repetition, I think, is what finally got math to click for my daughter Sophie, and I definitely feel like this is the same. One focus at a time, so they're not introducing a whole lot of different things at once. And then they're also really big on copy work.
All right, so the primary components that you use for Happy Cheetah reading are some flashcards, and there's in the kindergarten set, there are actually three different levels or three different sets of flashcards. Then you use readers, and there's actually three books. The first book, for some reason, we appear to have lost, but it's called My Family. So My Family is the first one, then Nana and Papa, which builds off the same characters and things that were in My Family. So it goes along really well, connecting old information to new information. And then the last book is called Things I Like. We haven't gotten to this one yet. And then you move on to first grade level. And then it also comes with letters. We put ours in this sorting box just to make it a little bit easier, but it does come with a set of magnetic letters, uppercase and lowercase, and red vowels. And then it also comes with a magnetic whiteboard that has lines on it. Okay, so all of this was in the kindergarten box. Okay, it actually comes with two workbooks. We do not have the first workbook. We didn't need it, and we passed it along to somebody else, but the first workbook is called Getting Ready, and it's for early kindergarten. Possibly even some students might do well with it in preschool. And it says, in the Getting Ready workbook, your student will learn to write all capital and lowercase letters quickly and easily, copy short sentences like my fish is orange, identify the connection between sounds and letters, accurately write short words such as lag, mug, and fed, properly write his or her name starting with a capital letter and using lowercase letters. So that's the focus for the first book. And Sophie had all of those skills mastered and learned the phonics from Foundations Phonics by Masterbooks. So we moved directly into workbook one. And so I want to give you kind of an overview of this book. So they say that context, copy work, and calmness are the three C's of successful reading, and that's the way the program is based. It tells you here the guidelines on how to use Happy Cheetah Reading. So there's notes to the parent. There's no additional parent or teacher book. Everything is in this one workbook, so that does make it very easy to use. And so this is the very first lesson, and so the instructor will read these stories. This was in the first book called My Family, and that was the whole lesson for lesson one. Then you start reviewing for several lessons in a row. So this was the very second lesson. So this again would be for a student who has mastered phonic sounds and can write their name. So it says what you're going to read, and the student starts by reading the story, My Family. Now it's very repetitive. This is the actual story right here. So it's in the book as well as in the workbook. And so for the first lesson, they usually will read the story or the introduced story again. Then you work with magnetic letters. And so it tells you the words that you're going to be having them spell. And so you build and read the first word, then, the following word on the list, you change the letter, and then at some point the student starts doing this. Right now Sophie's doing that by herself. I'll tell her the word to make and she sounds it out and builds it. Then they have games in the back of the book to use with the flashcards. We are, I guess we're not that fun. We just simply do them as flashcards because we can get through them quicker. And with Sophie's special needs, I feel like doing as many as possible is good for her. And it doesn't take us very long, so we simply use the cards as flashcards. But they have several different games in the back of this book that you can do if you want to be, want to add some fun to that. But this is going to be something that's done in most of the lessons, especially at the beginning of the book. Then there's always a section called Think and Do. So this says draw a line between the letters that are the same, so matching the uppercase to lowercase. This was very easy for Sophie at this point. Then it says circle the words that look right. There's a lot of grammar that's introduced. You know, does the sentence start with a capital letter once you get a little further in the book? And here are did they use the correct, capital letter for the first letter of the word and that kind of thing. And then draw a line between the words that are the same, again, noting the capital letters. And then on the last thing, it says read the words aloud, circle the words that rhyme. So there is a big focus on
sight words, in my opinion, with this curriculum because of the flashcards as well as the extreme repetition with the little readers that they do. This is a very good example of the beginning book, what the stories look like, but at the same time, there's always a focus on rhyming and building words that are similar out of the magnetic letters. So then there's a copy work page. So really you could probably just use this for your handwriting as well. We haven't yet abandoned our The Good and the Beautiful Level 2 handwriting because Sophie likes it. But next year, I'm not really sure that I will get a separate handwriting book because I plan to use this next year. And with handwriting built into it, I just don't know that I need to really add anything else. So in the beginning of the book, there's a lot of focus on writing the first name, being able to write it from memory, spelling it and all that. Sophie was not able to do her last name, so I actually wrote it and she traced it. And then you just do the handwriting that it shows on the page. And then that's the end of the lesson. I would say this lesson probably took us about 15 to 20 minutes. Usually, now we're a lot further in the book now, but the lessons usually take us no more than about 30 minutes. Okay, then when you go to the next lesson, it's gonna have some letter boxes and it gives you some words on the right-hand side that are very small. And you're supposed to use these words. It took me forever to realize that these words were over here. So what I would do is it would say focuses on the short A. So I would just, you know, give her some words and what can we make with a short A? And you know, I would kind of help her through that. But after a while, I realized that there were actually words we were supposed to be using on the right-hand side. The next word is bog.
Bog. My
What do you think?
Oh.
Uh-huh. Bog. Bog. Very good listening. This is pretty much the same as what they did the previous day. You start out with reading. So you're still reading the same story. You're still doing the magnetic letters. You're still doing the flashcards, but then you're adding the letter boxes. And this is all, again, it's different information, but it's the same tasks. You're practicing the handwriting again. So you can see how repetitive it is, especially at this early level in this book. So this is going to be basically for a child that is just learning to read. They know their letter sounds, but they're not reading. And so this is when they will start learning to read because, you know, they're really just changing one word. They do have these little kind of, I don't think they consider them assessments, but I kind of treat them like assessments. So you'll do a review of your flashcards and then you're supposed to try to see if they can read these words. I do not time Sophie because she does have childhood apraxia of speech, so that's not very effective for her. But what I do with these is just have her read these to me cold. You know, we don't practice or anything. She just reads them. And so far on every single one, she's been able to get 100% and she's able to read it quickly, which is nice. Then they have a creative time, which is optional. And I don't do this with Sophie because it's like drawing a picture and then writing sentences about it. And with her handwriting disability, this is just a little bit too much right now. So this is not something we're currently doing. All right, so each one of the readers has a set of flashcards. So this is the one that goes with the last book, Things I Like. These are the ones that we're currently using. These are the few that we're still working on that she really doesn't have mastered. These are the ones that she does have mastered, which this is a phenomenal accomplishment for Sophie. And these are for the first book, which we can't find, called My Family, that she's completed, and the book Nana and Papa. So every reader has its own set of flashcards, and we're continuing to use the first set, even though we're done with that book. So I want to take a minute and show you the first grade level. When you get a box from Happy Cheetah, this is kind of what you're getting here. You're going to get all the readers that come with that level. So again, this is first grade level. All right, and they're in order, so it tells you, like, you know, when you would read what. So there are 6 readers for the first grade level. You get more magnetic letters, which of course we don't need because we already had some before we bought it, and then kindergarten came with magnetic letters, so it's more magnetic letters. And then there is book 2, which would be the very next book, called Cub Walking. And then this is book three, which is called Cub Running. This one is much thicker. And then there's some other sheets and explanations and things like that in here that we honestly didn't really use. And these little ABC cards, which we also haven't used. So I'm just gonna give y'all an idea of how these books compare. So this is the very first book, student workbook for the first grade level. All right, so it's starting out pretty similar. We're going to read the book, My Day, out loud to the child. These are the stories we're going to do, and that is the end of the first lesson. Then it looks like the lessons are honestly very similar to kindergarten. It's just that the stories are a little bit harder. So this is the story. They're going to read the story, My Day. They're going to do the magnetic letters. They're going to read it again, and then the think and do, circle the sentence that sounds right. Cross out the word that does not belong, underline the vowels, and circle the sentence that looks right. And then copy work. So it's very similar to what we're doing in kindergarten. I'm gonna flip through a little bit. It looks like we do still have the little assessments. One of the things that I noticed that they did start doing at the end of the kindergarten level is spelling. So here's their spelling list. So they have them practice, and then one more time with the spelling. So this would be the certificate for the first 16 lessons. I'm gonna flip over a little bit towards the end of this, and then we'll show the second book. This is lesson 58. It looks like there are 64 lessons in this book. So you're going to read, or in the book, We Have Fun. So that is this book. So they're going to cover two books, it looks like, book four and five in this workbook, and then move to the next workbook. So they read, they do the magnetic letters, the words are getting a little longer, read again, the stories are getting longer, think and do, circle the sentence that sounds right, cross out the word that does not belong, underline the vowel, circle the sentence that looks right, and copy work. So it's very similar, but the words are harder, the stories are longer. So now I'm going to show you the second workbook for first grade. And this book comes with four readers. And these are nonfiction. So we have home and farm animals, bugs and small animals, land and sea animals, and zoo animals. All right, so let's take a look at the beginning of this one. We're still starting the same way with the parent reading the stories to introduce. Still doing the reading, the magnetic letters, and then we're reading again the think and do and the copy work. One thing I have noticed is there does not seem to be any flashcards in the first grade level. So I guess they've introduced all of the sight words that they want to do or that they want to memorize like that. Then we still have the letter boxes and the reading, a lesson three, and then the copy work. So very similar, just a little harder. I'm going to flip to the middle of this book. So now we're at lesson 50. Still reading. It looks like they're reading four stories. They are still doing magnetic letters. They're reading it again. The stories are much longer. Still doing the think and do. Think and do looks to be the same. This is more of a grammar. And this, the first one is usually, are the words in the right order and does it sound right? And the second one is usually more of a grammar situation. Okay, and then copy work. These are sentences from the story. Our letter boxes are now bigger. Let's flip to the end of the book and see what this looks like. All right, there are 112 total. This still has spelling. All right, I'm going to go to the last section. All right, so these are the stories that they're reading and the zoo animals. This is an example of the story. So much longer, much more words. Magnetic letters, the words we're dealing with are shark, bark, dark, park, and then shark again. We still have think and do, and then the copy work are the sentences from the story. And then the next lesson is the letter boxes. And now they're focusing on digraphs, CH, TH, and SH. So that is different. And then these are the words, the sort of the assessment to be able to read quickly. And these are the spelling words at the end of the book. And then another assessment to see and say. And then the final reading assessment to be able to read the Komodo dragon story. And then the final certificate of achievement for lessons 97 to 112.
So like I said, Sophie right now is about halfway through the second kindergarten book. And I would say so far, this program has been fantastic for Sophie. She's made a lot of progress. She is reading now. She's able to pick up other books and read them. She's recognizing words out of context, you know, not just because it's in this sentence or in this book or beside this picture. You know, she's actually able to read. And so it has definitely increased her confidence. She's increased her phonics skills, the ability to rhyme. She struggled with that before Happy Cheetah. Even though she knew all of her phonics sounds and she recognized all her letters, knew uppercase, lowercase, all that stuff, she still was not really getting the concept of rhyming, and now she has that nailed. And also, I think she has really gotten a lot more sight words under her belt. So I definitely think that this is a really good program for children that have struggled to read with other programs, and especially for special needs students that may need more focus on sight words and not as much focus on phonics. So this program definitely teaches phonics, but there's a good bit of focus on sight words as well. And I think sometimes for special needs kids, especially with kids like Sophie who has childhood apraxia of speech, sometimes the phonics can be a little bit more difficult, and she really needs to have you know, a program that is at least going to cover sight words. If you have any questions about Happy Cheetah Reading, leave those in the comments below. I found out about Happy Cheetah Reading from my friend Katie at Life in the Mundane, so I'm going to go ahead and link her channel in the description box below, because she does have a couple of videos on Happy Cheetah Reading on her channel as well. I believe she covers in a little bit more depth the very first book, which we passed along and never used, so you may be able to get some information on that very first book in the kindergarten level from her. But if you have any questions, let me know down below. I'll do my best to answer those. But I'm really grateful that we found this program, because like I said, it has really been a game changer for Sophie. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll see you next time.